Hello, I'm Gaten from CrewFX. Today I'm glad to introduce you to Parallaxer 3 for After Effects. This version is more flexible, it's faster, and most of all, it's super fun to use. Transforming an illustration or a picture into a 3D parallax animation in After Effects has never been easier. For those unfamiliar with this tool, it provides you with the ability to move your layers in depth without affecting their appearance from the camera, something you cannot do by default in After Effects. In Parallaxer 3, you will find the highly effective tools for manipulating groups of layers in 3D space that made the previous version a success. But the real innovation here is the flexibility to add or convert 2D and 3D layers in both directions whenever you want. Okay, let's dive in. I'm going to show you how Parallaxer 3 works from the start. I'm in Adobe Illustrator, where I've separated my illustration into layers. Take the time to properly organize your layers in 3D space. Remember, layers on top will appear in front, and those at the bottom will be behind. Once satisfied with the result, switch over to After Effects. If you follow the steps to install the Parallax script included in the documentation, launch it by going to Window, Parallax 3. Import your illustration as a composition and choose the Retain Layer Size import mode. Both options are possible, but for this case, I want to preserve my layer sizes. Now, select your composition and launch Parallaxer to set up your scene. There is a message saying that locked layers will remain in 2D and that it will still be possible to add and convert layers. We will see that later. You'll be prompted to choose a type of scene preset. For this example, let's select the medium scene big room, which provides a stronger 3D impression than the small room preset. Parallaxer asks me to set up my viewport in two view modes, top and camera. Let's set up the two view modes like this. Top view for the left viewport and camera view for the right viewport. If you don't see anything in the top view, just de-zoom and recenter your layers. Now Parallaxer is active, as indicated at the top of the composition. I can move my layers in depth without affecting their appearance from the camera. That's pretty cool, isn't it? I can now move my camera with After Effects buttons, here, to test the result. Feel free to explore different angles to see how the layers move relative to each other. That will be helpful to adjust your scenes. If there's any lag, you can reduce the viewport quality to half or lower. I'm going to convert my background in 2D with the 2D Convert button because I don't need it to be in 3D. I just want a simple white background. It could have been done by locking the layer before applying Parallaxer to the scene. Let's return to the original camera position by simply clicking on Reset Camera. Let's put some colors on our layers for a clearer view. Blue for the man and his desk, red for the man and woman just behind, and yellow for the objects in the background. Let's put the man in the foreground, closer to the camera. If I move now, it's obvious he is now much closer. Let's put him back. I think the man is too far away from his computer. Let's correct this by reducing the distance between the two layers by using the minus button several times. Okay, it's better now. I want the objects in the background to be spaced further apart to enhance the 3D impression. So I click the plus button a few times and move them further back. If I wanted the man and woman to be at the same distance from the camera, I will use the flat button. This is very useful in many cases. And this is how easy it is to adjust any scene by positioning your layers in space with Parallaxer. Once satisfied with my setup, I can click on the Bake button. It's not essential to bake, but it will speed up your viewport, and it's recommended if you start doing some complex animations on the camera and layers. Please bear in mind that some Parallaxer functions will no longer be available if you bake the scene. If your layers become blurry as the camera gets closer, you can click on Rasterize Layer. For the second example, I proceeded the same way and added some animations on the birds and the flowers. Let's see how I did that with Parallaxer 3. I spent some time separating all the layers in Illustrator once again. Let's import it as a composition in After Effects. This time, before applying Parallaxer to the composition, I lock my background layer containing the clouds to keep them static and in 2D, just as in reality, very distant objects won't move with the camera. I'll add some colors, blue for my mountains, red for my birds, and green for my grass, flowers, and trees in the foreground. Let's launch Parallaxer with the large scene exterior presets. Well, this is already a pretty decent result. But if I move my camera, I can see the trees in the foreground disappearing immediately. That's because they are too close, and the grass seems a bit too far. I'm going to correct this by grouping all my foreground vegetal layers with the minus button and bringing them closer to the camera. Okay, this is better. Let's reorganize everything for more realism. Perfect. That's how easy it is to set up a 3D parallax on a complex scene with just a few clicks. And now I'm going to animate all these birds independently. To do that, the first thing to do is to select the layer and precompose it by right-clicking and selecting Precompose. Let's double-click on the new composition and make it bigger, just like this. The problem here is that I only have one layer, so I can't animate the birds individually. You have several options here. You can create a new file in Illustrator and separate all the birds, or you can use plugins like Explode Shape Layers or Overlord that can directly import objects from Illustrator to After Effects. In this case, I'm going to select my Illustrator layer and explode it with Explode Shape Layers. Now I have all my birds on separate layers and I can animate them. I'm returning to the main composition. Let's bake the scene because I'm satisfied with my setup. I'll animate my camera for 3 seconds and then do a preview. Okay, my birds are moving. And this is exactly how I animated these very complex scenes for the game Incredibox as a freelancer. The point here is to show you that you can convert one or several layers into precomps and animate them. But what if I forgot to import a layer or want to enrich my scene with new details and still be able to use Parallaxer on that layer for the setup? Well, in version 3, it's much more flexible. You can now add new layers, convert them with Parallaxer, even in baked scenes. It's never too late to add some details. I'd like to add this helicopter into the scene. Once imported into After Effects as a layer, I'll simply drag it into my scene, adjust its position and scale. Next, I'll use the Convert Layer button. Now, seen from the camera, my helicopter retains its size and position when I move it in depth. I can quickly place it on the horizon, like this, or in the foreground, within seconds. Parallaxer is applied to the helicopter layer, meaning there are expressions enabled for position and scale. It can stay like that, but if I want to speed up my viewport, or if these expressions are bothering me for animation, I can bake my layer. Now let's say I change my mind. I think that mountain over there is a bit too far away. I'll reactivate Parallaxer by selecting the layer and clicking on Add Layer. Be cautious though, if the scene has been heavily modified and/or animated, using the Convert Layer function might alter how the converted layer appears in the camera view. However, the layer will become dynamic again, and that's cool. Okay, so everything we've learned together to convert an Illustrator file into a 3D parallax and After Effects can be applied to a Photoshop file with layers. The result will be kind of flat sometimes, like cut paper, but most of the time it can be enough. For better 3D results on pictures, I recommend you take a look at Volumax 3D Photo Animator. You will find a link in the description of this video next to the Parallaxer page link. Thank you for watching this tutorial and for supporting my work. With all your feedbacks and ideas of improvements, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel to be informed about all the future releases. Thank you. Goodbye.